My dad wanted to find some sort of activity for us to do together, and he picked up snowboarding and taught me along with him. I don't remember much about learning. I just remember, like, my toes being cold and wanting an ice cream at the lodge.
My name's Parker Gonnet. I live in Washington. I started snowboarding when I was like 9 because my friend's older brother did. I grew up in the like Sugarbush community in central Vermont and just kind of fell in love with the community. It gets super rad to be able to go anywhere in the country that it snows and just immediately make friends because you have one similarity where your favorite thing is sliding down a hill on a piece of plastic and wood.
I've always sort of felt like the odd one out, and I felt the same way in college. Everyone went home for the summer, and I didn't have somewhere to go home to. Someone that I met told me that she was gonna go live in Portland, and I was like, oh my God, that's close to Mount Hood. Can I have a ride? So we went out there, and I just had my snowboard bag and a duffel bag. The next season, at the end of my first week digging to ride, we were all waiting at the bottom of the main lodge. They looked around, and they're like, hey, where's this kid? He's not here. And someone was like, why the fuck is Dig to Ride here, and he's not? She should have his job, because she clearly fucking wants it. I got the job. That summer was amazing.
UT Bounds is so close to my heart for a number of different reasons. They were the first camp that I went to. At the time, I didn't have any women that I wrote with. Just seeing someone who, like, I could identify with a lot better was really exciting. Snowboarding has given me that community that I didn't know where else to find.
I don't have any questions for you, and I wouldn't think of one if you'd ask me to. Hear me now, but you're gonna hit the street, fetch an overdose for me. And honey, let me be the one to be coming right to your side. Alright, I'll show you everything, and I'm stepping out of the light. Surprise.
My dad used to say it. It's like the girls can keep up with the boys or something like that. My dad would kind of just be like, nah, just beat them. I went through this funny phase where, like, I didn't want my hair out. I didn't want, like, to look like a girl. I think I wanted so badly to ride like the guys and learn from them and have that style.
The following year, they hired another female, and at first I was excited because this person had a lot of clout, you know? Like, they were sponsored and they were cool and they had the right clothes, and I mean, I was trying, but I was not, no matter what I wore, it was like not cool. You know, I was like, all right, sick. Like, I think these pants are awesome. And then people were like, what are you wearing? I kept trying my best, and I would like make sure to be the first one to the hill and the last person coming back. If we were carrying a rail and I took a bad step and stumbled, it was like, what the fuck, Laura? And I was like, no matter what I do, like, people are upset with me.
When you feel like you're no good, whether it's a company dropping you or falling and getting a concussion, fracturing your shoulder blade, breaking your ankle, all in the course of 2 hours, of course you're gonna wanna quit. The fear of quitting. I've invested so much time, energy into this. I don't know who I would be without it. It's given me the biggest sense of purpose in my entire life. And to not be a part of it, I would feel really alone and adrift.
And like getting made fun of when I fell to the point where I would hear the other female in the digger zone like screaming and cackling when I'd fall. And like maybe it wasn't always about me, but it seemed like it was just like a ringing in my ears, like every time I felt this person and people were laughing at me.
I feel like everywhere you go, there's kind of like a cool kids club. And I feel like that's the only bad thing about snowboarding is a lot of people feel left out of the cool kids club or whatever they want to call themselves, the people who act too high in society to hang out with everybody else, whether they're a beginner or expert. There's always going to be those people who feel too good for the next person. But if everybody just focused on themselves and having a good time and making sure that everybody around them was having a good time, it would just be a much better community.
Way before my insecurities, they were haunting me in my early teens. When the class of dragons despised,
What in the hell did I miss? Yesterday I was a kid. All the kids call me a freak. All the things I won't forget. And it got into my head. Every word almost a threat. Feeling alone every step. Was a trap, was a trap. Bruises and marks threw me down. Made me go linger around. Wanted to turn it around and move on and move on. Even boys can cry.
What I gather for a long time, it's been pretty structured about what you do. This is how you make a video part. This is how you do tricks. Your pants are too tight, your pants are too wide. All the different nuances that, from an outside perspective, nobody will see. Like, nobody is really noticing that except for the people who have decided to care enough. And I think that that's phasing out. And at this point, it feels like the people around me and the people that are coming up with me are bringing a really creative and open space. We all just want to see each other reflected in what we create, because I want to create what reflects me. It's time to expand, because it's all been done.
Way before my insecurities, there were haunting me in my early teens. When the clouds were dragons and spies, I was 007, listen to a smile. Just fading memories are left.
The craziest part about meeting Zeb is, like, he's just an everyday guy. He just happens to be really good at snowboarding. When you first see him, you think it's all just gonna be snowboarding. But then, like, if you actually get the chance to hang out with him, you realize it's more than just snowboarding for him. Never, ever, ever would I have thought that I was gonna meet him and get to hang out with him. Like, I thought it was gonna be if I see him, it would be like, oh man, what's up? I watch your stuff all the time, and he'd be like, sick. And then probably never see him again. But for him to actually give me the time of day, it means a lot. It means a lot, because, like, it just lets you know that, like, you don't have to be really good to fit in a community like snowboarding.
You were just recently in Banff for Its Tits. Tell me about that.
I was a digger, and then I got to ride, and I've never, ever, ever been to anything like that in my whole life. Like, it was kind of unimaginable that I would ever do it. So to get that opportunity and get there, I was already on a massive high. It was really cool to be around a group of 11 girls, and we just got the job done. We had a few discussions about it, about how hard it is to get to a certain level in the snowboarding industry when it comes to diggers as a female and not have some sort of feeling that you have to prove yourself still against females, because that's literally, like, what we have to do. Is a female has to really fight hard in the industry to be able to get a place and feel comfortable. And then put 11 of us in the same room together, we all have to be strong, maybe stubborn characters with big ideas, which could clash, but it didn't. We all just bonded so well. If a job needed to get done, it got done. Like, it was really, not to be cheesy, it was kind of magical. And then having all the girls riding as well was really, like, that just topped it off. The energy, females, and I said it a few times, to be riding along other women, that we were all stoking on each other. But being able to be at Its Tits and be able to just honestly be like, I am petrified to hit this and I don't know how to hit it. And someone else next to me be like, oh my God, me too. Like, I don't know what to do. But then we talked it out and we both hit it.
It might seem like a heavy undertaking for some, but for us to spend an entire winter shoveling and traveling and falling down flights of stairs for no better words, it's totally worth it. It's pretty much the same artistic expression for me as, I guess, painting or singing or playing an instrument or anything like that. It's a very unique experience, and I'm very, very grateful to see the world through that lens for a grand majority of my life.
That rewarding feeling and gratification from the ride away is like a high that you don't really get in day-to-day life. I try and make sure that I'm always having fun. Like, that's one thing for me, is that, like, snowboarding is not extremely serious all the time. Like, it's just supposed to be fun. I want to make sure that I'm having fun.
Something that I'd wish I'd known earlier was that there are just so many different paths you can take within snowboarding. There's just not one route to take to get to the next level. There are so many ways down the mountain. In the end, you're in charge of your own riding. You're in charge of the way your creativity flows. That's like the best thing about snowboarding.
It's like such an expression of joy. It's just your body floating through space, and it's like, how can I, just purely for my own joy, like experience flight and speed and movement and momentum and then twisting. It's this really kind of mystical, spiritual, like visual art almost. It's so fun to watch people do it because the joy is just so deep that it's infectious, you know? It's just so rad.
Some of my favorite events to attend are events that are community-based. You're on the hill and you're hiking with your homies and you're all hitting the same feature. It creates a really cool environment where you feel like you're all in it together. Laura, her mental meetups have a really special place in my heart because we can go on hill and ride with our homies, but then come down and have a real meaningful conversation and connect with people.
Coaching to me is one of the most important things that I've probably done since I've touched a snowboard, just because the act of turning has brought me so much joy in my life, and it feels very, I guess, just right to pay it forward and give kids the same opportunity to experience joy the way that we do and see the world for, I guess, the playground that it is.
I'm a very go-with-the-flow gal and just want to use my smile and easygoing vibes to make people happy. I'm also half Filipina and half white, and really proud that I've always been authentically myself. My hope is that people can see the joy snowboarding brings me and that it inspires them to give snowboarding a go as well.
I would just say, like, I found for myself, like, getting a career in snowboarding was, like, very important and, like, my way to, like, contribute and give back to something that means so much to me. And so, like, if you can find your place in the sport, however it may be, doesn't necessarily have to be, like, you're doing double corks. You just have to, like, make sure you're having fun and finding your place however you feel comfortable, and hopefully people are supporting it. And as long as you're happy, who cares?
Since the first year of Take the Rake, there's just been way more girls getting hired to park crew and applying to park crew, so seeing that has been so rewarding. The thing that surprised me is that we're all the same and we all deal with the same battles, and some days we might all cry on the hill because we feel like we suck at snowboarding. Everybody feels that way. Even people who are sponsored and get money for it have shitty days too. It's like, everybody's just a homie. Everybody is nice and we're all bonded by one love, and that's snowboarding. And that's so special. I don't think a lot of people get that.
It was so, so different going with a group of people where we're like, yeah, we're just out here to have a good time and get clips, but like, we're not worried about out tricking each other, and we're not worried about like, oh, if you do the same trick as me, like yours is better, so they're not gonna use mine. It didn't matter. We were just out there snowboarding because we loved it and because it felt good. It made me excited about snowboarding the streets again, because it also showed me that it doesn't have to be something so gnarly that you feel like you're gonna have a heart attack just from hitting it. And it doesn't have to be like trying to do the craziest shit. It can just be going out and snowboarding with your friends, not at the resort, and giggling and laughing and supporting each other.